ricordo, insomma, la storia. Abbiamo CP anche io. Drogba.
Ah, mica sa.
Sa hatu DJ Drogba.
Hatu. Na me pabo la gawa sema we bia
sima. We za zo wa. Ino! DJ hatu. Sa ino!
Ah, oye, oye. Oye, ya sa fa.
Happy.
Meanwhile, New Love goes down in the box, and there's a yellow card.
That was a simulation. He deliberately went down. He traumatized his fall, and so definitely the referee must penalize him. Kudos to the referee. For me, I think, Prince, the first 45 minutes, the referee was really fair to the two teams. He has actually lived up to my expectation. Let's hope he's going to translate the same performance in the second 45 minutes.
Well, there you have New Love on the ball, a recap of what exactly happened. Well, I would want to agree with Amin Lamte. Seems to have taken a dive, and referee was right there on the spot and has rightly booked New Love. And so, yellow card for New Love of 7 United, although he's picked up some pain. Let's look at the slow-mo again. He beat one person and then Well, you could say that the defender had a leg stretched out, but he sort of tumbled over the leg, let's put it mildly. So, and want the free kick to be retaken. Referee KJC from Insawam. So far, so good, at least in the first 45. And I'm sure he would continue to do what he knows how to do best in this second half. So, free kick affected by Isaac Boabing. The heads will go up. Kwachi misses. Fair point. Still have the advantage. Isaac Adu. Isaac Adu brings the ball back to Asari. Asari sends a cross in. Wasn't dealt with properly, but fair point. Still have the advantage. Now they're moving threateningly from the right or the left, as it were. Chance coming the way of fair point. Well, he did control the ball very well, but the agility of James Tobolu was called into action once again, and he has calmly weathered the storm. 4-7 United.
I told you a while ago that naivety would be a very, very huge problem for the fair point team. Look at this golden opportunity. I would have thought that the guy would just control, or probably he would just, as the ball got to him, would just run the ball behind the goalkeeper. Let's look at the slow-mo here. Why would he want to go control the ball before putting the ball behind the goalkeeper? So for me, that is game of football. Let's hope he would actually come on with another opportunity and be able to utilize it.
Well, that was a close shave there for 7 United earlier on, and nothing came out of that. But the game still continues, and 7 United have New Love to thank for, and New Love still controls in the midfield, turns round, trying to get the ball through to Inkum, but it was short-lived. Now this is Razak. Razak setting up men forward for fair points. There's a chase for it on the far side. He would allow the ball to roll over the line, yes. And it is a throw-in, quickly effected. And fair point, cutting in. This is Paul Adu. Paul Adu sends the ball back. It's a long cross to the near side where Isaac Adu would control. He sends in a cross, clash in the box. And two players. One each from both sides, go down. And that was a clumsy clash.
And we don't have the St. John's ambulance men here with their stretchers to stretch these players off the pitch. That is one thing that we've seen. As I said, this is the slow-mo of that incident. Less over, these players will get up and continue with play, and you can see him rolling, gnashing and holding his head in agony. So what I'm saying is that let's hope next week in the second league matches, and St. John's ambulance men will be invited to come and see to this particular problem that we have today, Prince.
Well, Fred Kwachi seems to be up, and the referee says the game should continue. This is Gabriel. Gabriel sending a long one in, trying to get to the captain, Abito. Abito was dispossessed, and fair point will take over at this stage. Good ball control by Abu. Neat turn in midfield there. Now fair point trying to put the pieces together. Abdul Razak, can he get to the ball? Yes, he does, but that attack has been short-lived, and ball had traveled over the line. Kwachi could not get there early enough. It is a throw-in to fair point at this stage, and Isaac Adu, one of the two Adus of the team, effecting the throw-in. Ball comes back to him. Gets Charles Asari to help in the support and the build-up. Abdul Razak brings the ball back to Isaac Adu. Isaac Adu dispossesses one man. He's still moving threateningly forward. He fires, but nothing came out of that attack from Isaac Adu. Enterprising and daring enough. Fullback for fair point. Of course, he's been joining the attack when it matters most, especially from the flanks there. A solo effort by Isaac. He took the shot. The idea was open. Again, the execution wasn't that good. Meanwhile, ball goes over the line for a throw-in coming the way of 7 United. New Love in your shot. He's been working tirelessly in the first half and the second half. Unfortunately, he's picked the yellow card. Throw-in to be effected by Godfred Inkum. Inkum throws to Bakayoko. Bakayoko heads the ball down clumsily enough. It's been cleared. And fair point. Charles Asari pushing men forward. There's a run for the ball. A chance coming the way of Fairpoint, but timely clearance there from Jackson Ejepong in your shot. That was neatly done. There was no problems at all. He had the attacker had him under pressure. There you can see. And he took his time and ballooned the ball out of danger zone. New Love takes over for 7 United. Moving threateningly on the left flank. New Love. He comes down from an attack from Charles Osari. Referee would give the advantage to 7 United at this stage. New Love has been pushing and piling pressure with support from the chap behind the ball, the 17 shirt, Nanayao. And they've been helping Ibrahim Bakayoko with the crosses. There's another cross, meanwhile. There was a clearance there. And it's a ding-dong battle at this stage. Paul Addo would put the ball down for Osei Kofi. Osei Kofi trying to push his men forward.
The defensive network of Seville United. It looks like this time around, and he's really, really finding things very difficult. Anytime he's on the ball, you could see that he looks very tired. Let's hope the coach will see how best he could actually bring him out and bring somebody who will come and infuse some agency in their game.
Well, Seville United haven't made any substitution as yet, and so they do have options on the bench. And for the tactical disposition of the game, we'll leave it to the coaches. But that was a clash in the box there. What is referee going to give? Was that outside the box or in it? Two players are down, Ridwing in pain, and Godfred Inkum for 7 United. That was a clash from the slow-mo. I think there was, yes, Godfred went in for the ball, but unfortunately missed completely and ran into the 7 United player. There you can see him clutching his head. That was a throw from Isaac Addo. It was brought down there by the 7 United defense, and in his bid to clear the ball, Godfred Inkum ended up clearing the man instead of the ball. And there you see him clutching his shin in pain. Well, it looks dicey. And it looks dicey in the sense that referee has not taken a decision as yet as to whether it is a penalty or is not a penalty. And from the referee's point of view, he thought that it happened outside the box, and we need to give him the benefit. We need to give the referee the benefit of the doubt. He is the man in charge and the man in the middle.
He's the man in the middle. We can see that vividly that the guy was brought down.
Well, let's not belabor that point. It is an indirect free kick, and so, like I said, let's give the referee the benefit of the doubt. Replay says it was in the box. Referee says it was outside the box, and it is an indirect free kick to Fairpoint. Now, this is a five-man wall of 7 United, and I can see Charles Asari behind the ball. Abdul Razak sends it in, but wasted effort from Fairpoint United.
And that is expected, because if you look at the first half, they had about 3-4 free kicks closer to the vital area of Seville United. They couldn't utilize them, so I wasn't surprised that they couldn't make any positive use of this particular opportunity. But yet again, even before you leave me, you said we shouldn't be late in this issue, but I saw it. You saw the slow-mo. It was right in the box. The guy was brought in the box. Probably it was the assistant referee who was supposed to assist the referee and let him know that the guy was brought right in the box, Prince,
to make a save before Bedia Addo and his colleagues could latch onto that. And game still continues with just about 14 minutes gone in the second half. Fairpoint are down by a lone goal scored in the first half by Ibrahim Bakayoko for 7 United. Free kick coming the way of 7 United. At this stage, Captain Abito behind the ball. A referee would ensure that the defense wall positions itself well, as it were, goes back the distance. And Ibrahim Bakayoko behind the ball is going to, are we going to see a pile from Ibrahim Bakayoko? He looks solid enough to send in one. Sends in a cross. He hits the bar. Did it drop behind the line? That is also another talking point there. But that was a pile from Ibrahim Bakayoko. And Fairpoint dealing with it. Well, the ball went out. And so the advantage still stays with Seven United. This player has exhibited that he has the power.
Not even you. You were using the word a pile. This was a pile. It is more than the word a pile. This is really a cracker of a shot. Because look at that. And I don't know, it's really a bit marginal whether it really crosses the line or not.
No, I don't think so.
You don't think so, but that is your opinion. Let's see the replay again. But I think Bakayoko is the man of the day. He's really giving them run for their money. Bakayoko is a player to watch when you talk about Polytank Division 1 here in Ghana.
My oh my, the crowd, the Spurs crowd here were on their feet, expecting that that would be a goal. Another chance for Ibrahim Bakayoko, and this time it goes wide. There he clutches his face. The missed tell you. Well, substitution there for Seven United as they bring on player number 11, Zakaria Mutawakilu. And Mutawakilu in place of let's get this right, Godfred Inkum. Yes, well, Godfred could not survive that attack a couple of minutes ago. And Bakayoko heads on again. Fair point. They need to watch this chap Bakayoko very well. Kwachi coming with support coming from Jackson and moving forward. Or are they controlling the ball beautifully? And a lovely one there by Osei Kwachi. Bakayoko has been dispossessed this time, but new love piling the pressure. New love has been brought down. Push from behind, says the referee. And it is a free kick to Seven United.
I told you, but for me, and the new love need to be substituted, because it looks like now there's team in. Look at the replay again. That was the kick that was taken by Bakayoko. Very, very marginal. Prince, and I believe that it did not cross the line. But I said that there's a possibility it has really crossed the line. But all the same, and this is another free kick, and Bakayoko has rallied. So look at him again. He nearly got it. And for me, this is a young chap that needs to be worked. Because for me, Prince, players like Ibrahim Bakayoko is enough to actually be drafted into the marketing draft of Division 1. Because this is a chap each and every football follower in Ghana will love to watch him when he's playing. For me, Bakayoko is a fantastic chap in today's game.
Well, 17 minutes gone in the second half. Seven United still leading by that solitary goal scored in the first half through the man of the moment, Ibrahim Bakayoko. And I tell you, he is indeed the man to watch in this Division 1 league, especially the Polytank Division 1 league, I should say, for Seven United. Kwachi controls, but referee's whistle had gone a couple of seconds earlier. And it is a team manager of Polytank, Mohamed Amin Lamte. And of course, I couldn't agree with him more. And for Polytank to come on board to support Division 1 League, which is now known as the Polytank Division 1 League, I think they need all the support they can get. And of course, who else to give them that first support but Metro TV? And of course, through the kind courtesies of the Ghana Football Association, this marriage is going to blossom and blossom well. Substitute coming on for Fairpoint, and I can see Emmanuel Addo. Looks like there are so many Addos in the Fairpoint team. I don't know whether they all come from the same family, but there are so many Addos in the team, and we'll be finding one joining, or we're seeing one joining their colleagues on the field anytime soon. Meanwhile, is a free kick effected on the far side by Gabriel. It's a long one. It's been headed on by New Love, who's moved over to the right-hand side. And can Ivan Scranting maintain? No, he cannot maintain it. And the ball is kicked over. Meanwhile, it hits the captain of the field.
To me, turned your baby into a lady. And mama, all you had to offer know.